vinyl holder, it would give us more seat sitting room.
Yeah, that's true.
What does it wear?
Maybe downstairs.
Yeah, that's fine.
So everybody who doesn't know, this is Michael, and he lives here.
Hello. Woo. Welcome everyone to Loft Music. This is the first of its kind, hopefully. And essentially it's just going to be a nice small space for everyone, all these artists, all these local artists to perform and just chill and have a good time. So let's make some music, y'all. So I'm gonna play a few songs for you guys. The first one I'm doing, kind of a thing for playing music in different languages. So this one's a Japanese song called Kinakoin. It's about a girl who lost her dog, so she's like singing about like what it looks like and how to get it back and asking people if they've seen it kind of thing. It's kind of sad. If any of you have seen Cowboy Bebop, and if you choose that,
an intrusive.
You'll see. And also, set up a lyrics super well, so if you know the lyrics,
that would be appreciated.
Combination.
You can only choose one.
Purple.
Oh.
Right.
I appreciate that.
How long have you been playing?
Playing with you? 6 months.
Did you teach yourself?
I play guitar for since I was about 10 years old. My dad taught me how to play the old six string. And I only really used it like from middle school to like impress girls and shit. So I wasn't very good until like high school. And then I started actually getting good. I came to jazz in college.
But what
computers?
Are you studying at CU?
So I studied at CU?
Yeah.
I studied computer science.
Oh, nice.
Nerd.
What?
Nerd. Nerd. Nerd.
Yeah, you couldn't tell from the Japanese song, like, how the nerd is.
Nerd alert.
Do you have, like, who's one of your most, like, influential artists? Somebody that's really, like, helped shape your sound, or somebody that you look to that really gives you inspiration?
I would say,
guitar. Eilish.
Yeah!
Not the
help. Hey, man. Her songs are catchy as hell.
Alright, Ariana Grande.
As far as jazz goes, Wes Montgomery is one of my biggest inspirations.
Yeah.
So George Benson, who's really like my favorite guitarist of all the time. Also, like Eric Johnson.
Hell yeah.
Jim Davis. Yeah, and also Frank Ocean's a huge inspiration, but like more like in life,
like
maybe
use
it someday.
Yeah, yeah.
True.
Yeah,
like
as a musician, things that just sort of bug you, like in
somebody
else's music.
So, oh, and anybody else's music?
Yeah, yeah.
So I think like, well, first off, the biggest tip, he's like as a musician, just like being a guitarist, everyone's like, yo, play me this, like.
Right.
Well, if you ask me like today, you're like this. that's kind of pet peeve, because I'm more just like play and make my own music, and I'm kind of bad at colors and so on.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. This next song I need my phone, so Chris, can you
need your phone?
Turn off the line.
Sounds like a cowboy.
This is an original tune. It's called "Ode to George Benson." It's kind of like that jazzy, like funk, type tune. I haven't ever played it like over a backing track before, so yeah, that's it.
Yeah, I'll send Aaron an email or something.
Thank you.
Glee and Michael.
Glee.
G.
That's our name.
Oh.